Today we are going to study about rare animals of Nepal. We will cover the 7 animals of Nepal which are listed in the protected list of Nepal. You know that there are 27 species of mammals which are in the protected list, 9 species of birds are in the protected list, and 3 species of reptiles are in the protected list of Nepal. So among them, today we are going to study about 7 such animals, rare animals of Nepal. So 5 are mammals, 1 reptile and 1 bird species. So we will talk about them in detail. So the first one is clouded leopard, or in Nepali it is called Dhwase Chitua. So you can see the picture of clouded leopard here. Now let's go for the detail about this Dhwase Chitua or clouded leopard. We will go point wise. Okay, some facts about clouded leopard. So we will go point wise. I have already said its scientific name is Pardophelis nebulosa. You have to remember this, Pardophelis nebulosa. It is its scientific name, and its habitat is the mid hills of Nepal. They can be found in mid hills of Nepal, and they are conserved in Lamtang National Park, Makaluburun National Park, Annapurna Conservation Area. And talking about their physical appearance, if we talk about its length, it is 60 to 120 centimeter long, and its tail is about 78 to 85 centimeter long, and it is 16 to 20 kg weight. It has 16 to 20 kg of weight, and its outlook is attractive. So it is a very attractive animal. And if you see its color, it is gray or earthy brown in color. It is pale or rich yellowish brown in color, and its underpart is white or tawny color, and face strips on cheeks. If you see on the cheeks, and they, it has got strips or lines, you can see. And here it is, its underpart is white or tawny in color. So what do you mean by tawny? This is tawny brown color, so it has got this type of color. So you can see here the physical appearance. It has the tawny color, you can see yellowish brown color, tawny color. And look here, underpart, and look here in the cheeks, it has got strips, lines. So it looks very attractive, you can see. So let's go to next slide. Talking about its gestational period. Gestational period means its pregnancy period lasts from 85 to 93 days. Almost 85 to 93 days means almost 3 months. And litter size, number of born babies at the same time. At one time, it gives birth to 1 to 5, but commonly 2 babies. It gives birth to 1 to 5 babies, or just commonly 2 babies, minimum 1 and maximum 5. And its special feature is it does not attack humans as other leopards do. Other leopards, they can attack human beings, but it does not attack humans. This is its special feature. And its prey is small mammals and birds, means it eats small mammals as well as birds. And why is it rare, or what are the reasons for its rareness, and what are its usefulness? Hunting for teeth and skin. So its reason for rareness is hunting for teeth and skin. Many people hunt it for its teeth and for its skin, means its teeth and skin are very useful. So it is the main reason for its rareness, or you can say these are the usefulness of clouded leopard. So teeth and skin are very useful parts. And in the IUCN status, it is in the vulnerable status. So IUCN has listed the animals in different list: vulnerable, endangered, and many other list. Among them, so IUCN status is in vulnerable status. It has the status of vulnerable. And the next animal is called red panda, or in Nepali it is called habre. You can see the picture of red panda. It is very beautiful animal, so we can know about its features. Let's see some facts about red panda. Its scientific name is Oilurus fulgens, and its habitat is Lamtang, Makaluburun, Dorpatan, Rara, Sagarmatha, Kanchanjunga and Gaurishankar areas. So you can see 1800 to 3800 meters from sea level. And talking about its physical appearance, it is 64 centimeters, almost 64 centimeter long, and its height is 28 centimeters, and its tail is 28 to 48 centimeter long, and its average weight is 3 to 6 kg. It is small cute animal, and if you see the color, face and underparts are white and other parts red. You can see here its face and underparts. This face and underpart means the stomach area is white. Here you can see these ears are also white, but other parts are red in color. And it has got rounded head. You can see its head is a bit round in shape, rounded head, large pointed ears. You can see large pointed ears and little muzzle or nose. Muzzle means nose or snout. You can see in the little muzzle, this is called muzzle, little muzzle, and hairy legs. Its legs are hairy, and the legs are not seen here, so covered with hair. Let's go to next slide. So its gestational period is 4 months. It can carry its baby in the stomach for 4 months, means its pregnancy time is of 4 months, and at once it can give birth to 1 to 4 babies, minimum 1 to maximum 4 babies. Its special feature is it is very beautiful and cute animal, beautiful, small and cute. And its main food is bamboo, grasses, fruits, or ningalo. In Nepali we say ningalo. So why it is rare? What is its usefulness? So especially this red panda is hunted for skin and its soft fur. Its skin and soft fur are very useful, so people hunt it for skin and fur. And in the IUCN status, it is in endangered state. It is listed in endangered state. When we talked about clouded leopard, it is in vulnerable state, and it is this red panda is in endangered state. Now let's move on to next animal, that is one-horned rhinoceros, or it is also called Ekshinge Goira. Okay, let's know about some facts about rhino. All of you know rhino, but what are its facts? Let's see. Its scientific name is Rhinoceros unicornis. Please remember, Rhinoceros unicornis. And its habitat is Shivalik and Tarai region of Nepal. And it lives in swampy grassland and tropical jungle with sal forest. Especially you can find it in sal forest, tropical jungle of Tarai region. And it lives in swampy grassland. What do we mean by swampy grassland? In Nepali we call it daldal. Okay, swampy. So it is also called marshland. You can see some photos about swampy grassland. This is swampy grassland. You can see here. So especially rhinoceros live in these areas, swampy areas, marshland. Okay, so these rhinoceros, one-horned rhinoceros, are conserved in Chitwan National Park. Chitwan National Park is very famous for this one-horned rhinoceros. Bardia National Park, Parsa Wildlife Reserve, and Shukla Phanta Wildlife Reserve. In these areas they are conserved, especially in Tarai region. And talking about its physical appearance, it is 300 to 315 centimeter long, means almost 3 meters, and it is 180 centimeter high, and its average weight is 2000 to 2500 kg. It is a very huge giant animal. And it has got thick shield like skin folds cover the body. It has thick shield like skin folds in its body. So this, its skin is so thick, and it has the folds It is very much strong, and its head is boat shaped, and it has got one horn. It is its speciality. You can see it has got the skin folds. Look here, these are the skin folds. They are very thick, even bullet cannot affect it. So this is thick skin folds, and it has boat shaped head. Look here, this head is shaped like the boat, and it has got only one horn. So it is called Ekshinge Goinda. It has only one horn. So if we talk about its gestational period, it carries its baby. The female rhino carries its baby for 15 to 16 months. Its pregnancy period is 15 to 16 months. Human beings have the gestational period of 9 months, but rhinos, one horn rhinos, have 15 to 16 months. Its litter size is one baby, means at once it can give birth to one baby. And it eats underwater plants and grasses. And why it is rare? Because it is hunted for the horns. Its horns are very useful. So rhinoceros are hunted for their horns. And in IUCN status, it is listed in endangered state, same like red pandas. And number of rhinos in Nepal, according to Rhino Census 2015, is 645. We have 645 rhinos according to Rhino Census 2015. Okay, let's go on to next animal. That is very beautiful animal, Bengal tiger. It is also called Pate Bagh in Nepali. You can see the picture of Bengal tiger. It is very beautiful animal with stripes. Look here. Its scientific name is Panthera tigris. Please remember Panthera tigris. And its habitat is the forest and grassland of Tarai region. And it is conserved in Chiton National Park, Parsa Wildlife Reserve, Bardia National Park, Banke National Park, and Sukla Fata National Park. Talking about physical experience, its average length is 240 to 310 centimeters, including its tail. And its length of tail is 85 to 110 centimeter long, and its average height is 90 to 110 centimeter. Its weight is 130 to 200 kg. It weighs up to 200 kg. Talking about its color, it is yellow to light orange in color. So its coat outer cover is yellow to light orange. You can see yellow or light orange in color. Black or brown strips can be seen. Look here, these strips lines, they are black or brown. Belly and interior parts is white. This lower part, the part under under parts or stomach part, can be white in color. Belly means stomach part, and interior part means inner part. And tail is orange with black rings. Look here, the tail is not seen here. So in the tails you can see black rings. Okay, its gestational period is 3 to 4 months, and it can give birth to 3 babies at a time. And it is hunted for its skin, especially for its head and for other organs. In IUCN status, it is in the endangered status. So let's go to next animal, that is Asiatic elephant, or it is called Hathi. Okay, in Nepali it is called Hathi. Okay, you can see the picture very well. This is Asiatic elephant. And talking about the facts of Asiatic elephant, it must be interesting for you. Its scientific name is Elephas maximus. Its habitat is plain and plain land below Churia range of Tarai region. Conserved in Japa, Parsa Wildlife Reserve, Chitwan National Park, Bardia National Park, and Sukla Fata Wildlife Reserve. Its physical appearance, look here, you can see the average length 5.5 to 6.5 meters. Including trunk and tail. Look here, how long is it? 5.5 to 6.5 meters. Please imagine, including tail and trunk, it is maximum 6.5 meters long. And only its tail is 1.2 to 1.5 meters long. Talking about its height, look here, 2.5 to 2.75 meters high. And you can imagine its weight. Look here, 4000 to 5000 kg. Once you imagine what is your weight, maybe maximum 80 kg or 60, 70, 80 kg. But this Asiatic elephant is 4000 to 5000 kg. Please imagine. And it has long trunk, big head, large ears, stumpy legs, and long tusk. Look here, tusk. Do you know? Look here, you can see here. It has a huge body. Look here, long ears, long trunk. This is trunk, the tail, and stumpy leg. Look here, it has stumpy leg, flat stumpy leg, and its tusks, long tusks are there. So this is its physical appearance. Let's go to next slide. So it has 22 months of gestational period. So I have already said human beings have got 9 months of gestational period, whereas elephant has got 22 months. You imagine, 22 months, almost 2 years. And it can give birth to only one baby at a time. What are the reasons for its rareness? Look here, these elephants are poached or killed for its ivory. For its ivory means elephant tusk is called ivory. So its ivory or its tusk is so much useful that people poach it, or people illegally hunt it or kill it. So in IUCN status, it is in endangered list, and there are 130 to 150 elephants left. So it is in critical condition. It is a rare animal. Now let's talk about next one rare animal. It is giant pied hornbill. It is under a bird category. So this is also one of the protected animals of Nepal. So it is a bird, giant pied hornbill. It is also called Thulo Dhanesh in Nepali. You can see the picture here. And its scientific name is Buceros bicornis. Please remember, Buceros bicornis. Many points you have to remember. Instead of understanding it, you have to set these points in your mind. So its habitat is dense forest of Tarai region. And these hornbills are conserved in Chitwan National Park, Banke National Park, Bardia National Park, Parsa Wildlife Reserve, and Shukla Phanta Wildlife Reserve. And talking about its physical appearance, its average length is 95 to 130 centimeter, and its average weight is 2 to 4 kg. And its color, look here, you can see face, underparts, and back are black in color, and tail is white. You can see face, underparts, and back. This face, underparts, down lower parts here, underparts, and backside black in color, and tail is white in color. Tail is not seen here. Tail is white in color. And its special feature is it is bright yellow and black cast on the top of its massive bill. It has got massive bill, means massive means very large bill. Bill means this big. This is very large, massive bill, big, and it has yellow and black cast on the top. Look here, this is yellow and black cast. This is called cast on the top. This is its special feature. And its incubation period for the mammals, it is gestational period, and for these birds, it is incubation period, means hatching period by bird. This is called incubation period. Is 38 to 40 days, and at once it can its litter size is 1 to 2 chicks. It hatches 1 to 2 chicks at a time. And why is it rare? The main reason is habitat loss and hunting for medicinal purpose. So these birds are hunted for medicinal purpose, and due to habitat loss they are becoming rare. And in IUCN status, they are in near threatened status. Okay, next animal, protected animal, is Asiatic rock python or Ozinger. It is under reptile category. I already said three reptiles are under protected list in Nepal. Among them, this is one, Asiatic rock python. You can see the picture very well. And let's see its scientific name. It is Python molurus. Its scientific name is Python molurus, and its habitat is places near wetlands and water sources in forest and grassland in torrid region. And if you talk about its physical appearance, its length is 7 meters. You imagine 7 meters of python, and its average weight is 90 kg, and its color whitish or yellowish color with the blotched patterns, means uneven patch of colors. Blotched means what? Uneven patch of colors. Its pattern is like this, whitish yellow in color. You can see whitish yellow in color, white and yellow mix, whitish yellow, and the patterns are uneven patches, blotched. Okay, these patterns are not even, they are uneven patterns, blotched patterns. And its special feature is it is non-venomous python species. This is the species of python which is non-venomous, means non-poisonous. It is not poisonous snake. And its main food is warm-blooded small mammals, amphibians and reptiles. It can swallow warm-blooded small mammals and amphibians and reptiles, means small goats, rabbits or other small mammals, deer, and amphibians and reptiles also. It can swallow it, but it is not poisonous. It is killed for making expensive bells. Look here, bells, bags, and it is also used for medicinal purpose. And it is believed to be poisonous. Look here, people believe that python is very poisonous, so they kill the python. These are the reasons for its rareness. And in IUCN status, it is in near threatened status.